we say? When they say go...
When they go low, we go to hell.
When they go low, we go to hell. They go to hell every single time.
We went to hell a few times in season 7.
I haven't gone to hell yet.
I'm just going to be honest with y'all.
I haven't gone to hell yet.
Hi, I'm Chrishell Stause.
And I'm Chelsea Lazkani. I am British Nigerian, and today I am sharing some of my favorite Nigerian dishes with my best friend while we talk about some of my culture and the tea on Selling Sunset season 7. I brought you one of my favorite Nigerian dishes, actually a combination of a couple of things. It's from my favorite restaurant by one of my great friends. His name is Chef Eros, and today we have fried rice,
okay.
Suya, which is like a seasoned beef, some okay. beans, and plantains.
Well, I'm starving, so I'm excited. I've never had Nigerian food. I'm excited to dig in. Okay. And okay, is anything really spicy?
The great thing about my friend's restaurant, he does this elevated Nigerian cuisines that are kind of have a little bit of a California flair, so it's not going to be super, super spicy as it would be in Nigeria.
Okay.
But it's really good.
This is a good place for me to start.
It's a good place for you to start. Yeah, yeah.
It smells amazing. Now, do you cook this at home?
Yeah, so I actually, it's funny because I started cooking probably when I was about 6 years old. There was this kind of rule in my household when my mom was cooking, everybody had to be in the kitchen. So, since I was 6, I've been in the kitchen with my mum. So when I started cooking spicy shepherd's pie or like the traditional American cuisine or like Asian cuisine, which I love to cook so much, it's just so much easier because I'm so used to cooking Nigerian food, which is really complicated. A lot of it can be acquired taste. We mix a lot of seasonings and a lot of harder to get ingredients. So some of the dishes can take 4 to 5 hours to cook.
Oh yes. My God.
Have you ever tasted jollof rice before?
I haven't.
Okay, so if I was to ever recommend any dish for anyone to eat, my first Nigerian dish would be jollof rice. It's famous.
Oh, okay.
There's different types of jollof rice. There's Nigerian jollof rice, there's Ghanaian jollof rice, there's Senegalese jollof rice, there's jollof rice from all different countries in Africa. And there's this ongoing war between what country in Africa has the best jollof rice.
And what is it exactly?
So it's a rice that's mixed in with like a red peppered stew.
Uh-huh.
And then some people add like prawns to it, shrimp. People add bay leaves to give it the flavor. Some people add vegetables, tomatoes, onions, and it's just like a flavored red rice.
Here we go. Can I take the spice or not? We will see. It's not too spicy.
It's not spicy.
I loved it. It was so, that would take a long time to cook.
Okay, people are gonna love you, by the way.
It's so delicious.
If you don't love jollof rice, everyone would be like, oh my God.
How would you not like that? I can tell someone literally was in the kitchen cooking this forever, and that's why I'm like, wait, don't take this one. I want this one.
You know, in Nigeria, we love spices. So on a scale of 1 to 10, this would probably be like a 1 for me. In terms of like spiciness, what would it be for you?
I don't find this super, maybe I didn't get a spicy bite, but that wasn't very spicy.
So is the show spicier than this?
Oh, this show, Selling Sunset Season 7, is going to pack a little bit more of a spice than this bowl. But my Season 7, I think my spice went up a little bit in 7. I'd had it. I'm happy to be sitting here eating food with you, Chelsea.
What's like the latest between you and Nicole? I know like last season you mentioned she needed a storyline, that's why she was coming. Do you still feel the same way?
I'm not gonna be accused of being a crackhead by someone who has nothing else to throw at me.
My opinion has not changed on her motives, to be honest, because there was every single time it was proven that what she was actually mad at was something else, then she changed she switched it up on me.
How do you navigate that? Because if someone actually has fundamental
beef
with
you,
Bri and I, we obviously were on separate like pages for many things.
Yeah.
That's easier to understand because there's a reason. When you're like, I don't know why you don't like me, that's such an awkward position to be in.
That's the most frustrating part, especially when, before this, I really genuinely thought we were friends.
Yeah.
So I think that makes it harder because I think, I had, something happen later in the season with Nicole. It's like, what is your actual reasoning?
I'm still dying to know.
To be
honest.
Genuinely,
I'm dying. Because I will never get over the first day filming season 6. We're in an office scene and you came to me and you're like, I think Nicole has it out for me. Like,
I did, yeah.
You were like, I don't want any drama.
Okay. And I will continue to say everything I say about you is true.
Like,
I don't know what the issue is. And I was like, no. I think it's in your head.
Yeah, you did. And I was like, you know what? You're right. That was,
yes,
that was,
that's
probably
what you
weird
said.
Because there was a lot
that's
going
what
on.
You said. And then I ate my words 2 weeks later at my own Broker's Open. I was like, oh shit, you were right. Suya is a peppered beef.
Okay.
Traditionally in Nigeria, this is made extremely spicy. When I say extremely spicy, I mean your nose will be running when you eat it. Reminds me of Nigeria, reminds me of home. We definitely don't use chopsticks to eat suya.
Okay.
But this is kind of cute though. What are we gonna do with this? Don't need chopsticks for suya. This is the type of thing that you'd get after you finish the club or you're at a party.
Okay.
They'd serve suya last.
Okay.
So it's like, it's not like a dessert, but it's like a little snack.
The orange makes it more spicy.
The orange makes it more spicy.
How spicy it is. So I'm ready. So I'm prepared.
Oh, so good. You know what, babe? You're gonna be fine.
Okay. Oh my God.
It's so good.
That is delicious.
It's so good. Ile Bistro.
Okay.
It's so good. We're both no stranger to beef on reality TV.
True.
I'm not sure how much reality TV you watch. I watch quite a lot.
Oh, same.
What's your favorite beef on reality TV so far that you can remember? Because there's so many.
Remember with New York, and she was, you know, on Flavor of Love, and it was her like fighting with Pumpkin. Hey, New York is one of my favorite reality TV characters of all time. And so I feel like now she's having a comeback, which I'm excited about because who's not gonna root for her?
The Real Housewives of Potomac, give me my life, I'm sorry. But those ladies know how to fight. They go low, we say, when they say go.
When they go low, we go to hell.
when they go low, we go to hell. They go to hell every single time.
That's delicious. What's this over here?
It's just vegetables. There's vegetables and then there's some pepper chicken on the side.
I like that. I love this spice.
It's so good.
I really like
it. But you'll see, it's starting to kick in a little bit. Can you taste it?
I do feel that.
And the more bites you take, the more it kicks in.
But I like it because it's like, you know, it's like tipping your toe in. It's not like hit you all at once. Okay. So now you have to give me the latest on you and Brie.
Okay. So season 6 was a lot for me. It was really, really heavy.
I apologize for talking about you and your situation. We won't mention any time Nick has another baby.
Yeah, well, good luck. You may have 85 more. I don't give a fuck.
And I actually, for the first time in my life, had some regrets. Because I was like, oh my gosh, I am a mother. She is a new mom, and I went in guns blazing, really being so judgmental, and it didn't align with the person that I want to be. So as we started filming season 7, the first thing I really wanted to do was apologize and say, like, I am so sorry for judging you and voicing those opinions upon first meeting you. And I went in with that apology, knowing that she may not be receptive to it because a lot of harsh things were said. As season 7 progressed, I kind of realized that I think she's so beautiful. She's obviously a hustler. We have those same, the hustler part
yes,
in common.
Like, we go at it.
But at the same time, we're very different. My kind of approach with Brie now is like, I just want to be like kind and respectful and see if something evolves in the future. And if it does, fantastic. And
I'm working on this bridge.
And if it doesn't, that's also good. But we're gonna respect each other, and I'm gonna respect her and respect her life. And that's where I'm at.
This makes invitations to everything much easier.
I had some regret, and I don't really say that frequently. I had some regret.
Listen, season 7, I had some regret too.
Famous Nigerian dessert is called pof pof. It's like a fried dough. It's kind of sweet. It's usually served warm, and you just kind of like take a bite of it.
Okay. It's like a donut.
It's like a donut. It's what we call like Nigerian donut.
It was really good.
What do you hope viewers take away from season 7?
I hope viewers take away from season 7 that there really are some really strong friendships. And I feel like, you know, you are seeing us at our good days and our bad days, but I'm hoping it comes through to viewers, you know, who we are as a whole person. Because listen, I want to keep my bills paid, but They really tried me.
You know, I completely agree with you. And I think that what I would love for viewers to really understand is that we're human. Sometimes you just don't like people. Yeah. And that just is what it is. And that is okay. But we're evolving as humans, and we watch back every season and we reflect and we're like, we could have done this better, because I think watching back seasons for me, it gives me perspective on things that I could grow and evolve from, and things that I'm like, you know what? You're better than season 5 and 6 yeah. in this situation.
And I think that that goes with like the takeaway in general is that, you know, we are really strong, confident women. Yeah. And when we work together, you cannot stop us.